What's going on, everybody? Ed0626 bringing you some World of Tanks gameplay today. And this gameplay here was a real butt clencher in some cases. I'll explain it hopefully as it goes on. But I'm playing on the map. I think it's called Cliffside or something. Some shit like that. And I don't usually do good on this map, but today with the T1 Heavy, I was able to absolutely slap a couple tanks, which I was pretty happy about. Also, if my voice sounds a little bit off, I was at a wrestling show the night before, so if it doesn't sound up to par, I sincerely apologize, but whew, that show was fucking crazy. So if my voice sounds a little bit fucked up, I'm okay with that. However, that's not the point of today's video. Today's video is about one of my favorite things in the sports world happening right this moment, and it's called March Madness. For those of you who live under a rock, it's basically the big NCAA college basketball tournament that happens mid to late March, although it kind of sucks that it starts late March, because I feel like if something's called March Madness, it should start, you know, probably a little bit earlier in the month. So it doesn't go into April. That's just my opinion, but you know, I could be wrong. Either way, I'm just going to talk to you guys about what my picks were for my brackets. Even though the brackets have already been busted, I'm just going to share with you guys my experience so far choosing brackets, watching the games, and so much. So I'll talk about the brackets first with the amount of time I have. So already in the first game, on Thursday, I made four brackets. Let me explain to you what my brackets were. So my brackets were as follows. My main bracket, I had Duke winning because Zion, and because the Knicks need a new draft pick and Zion's our best bet at even rebuilding this team properly. So I had Zion for one. Virginia, which is probably like a little bit of an off pick for me. Virginia was my second bracket winner. North Carolina was my third, and Michigan State, I thought, could hopefully end up winning this time around, so I chose them as my fourth. So as the bracket stuff's going on, first game of the day, Minnesota versus number 7 Louisville versus number 10 Minnesota, which I chose Louisville for two brackets. And this is, oh god, really quick, this is a real butt-clenching moment here. I had no idea that tank was there, beating down on me. And then when he realized that my the Panzer IV next to me was fucking him up, he was like, oh shit, what am I gonna do? And that's when I came in for the kill. So back to the Louisville game. So Louisville loses the game. It's the first upset, at least I consider it an upset, of the season, or of the tournament. And it's the first game of the tournament. So already two of my brackets are eliminated. The Duke and the, I think it was the Duke and the UNC Carolina brackets were already busted. What then proceeded next in my brackets was absolute fucking insane shit going on. It was basically, you know, my last two brackets, the Virginia and Michigan State, were then getting wins. You know, everything was going right. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, oh shit, I might have a good chance of winning money, because usually like five games into the tournament, I'm already done for. So I'm like, oh shit, so what am I going to do? So, what happened next was, you know, later in the day, number 12 Murray State faces number 5 Marquette. And I chose, stupid me, I chose Murray State in one of my brackets, and which was my Michigan State bracket. And then my Virginia bracket, I had Marquette, because Marquette was the self-proclaimed better team based on the seed they were in. Marquette loses to Murray State. Now Michigan State's my the Michigan State bracket's my remaining bracket. I go on to continue to win for another 12. I have 12. At this point, I have like 12, 13 games won in total, which is like the most I've ever had. I'm like, oh shit, first day I might be actually perfect. Oh my god. And then Seton Hall loses to Wofford in absolutely dominating fashion. And I was like, oh shit. And there goes all the hopes and dreams I had of a perfect bracket. However, I'm proud of myself thus far for making it. I'm proud of myself for making it as far as I actually did. I usually never make it that far. And then pretty much, you know, I haven't been able to pay attention much. There's been a couple more upsets that have happened. Let me take a look at the app I'm on right now. Virginia's still in, which is good. Oregon beat Wisconsin, which is a big upset in the first round. The second round's going on as we speak. But North Carolina won. Ohio State beat Iowa State. You know, this is all the first round, man. Some big shit's going on. And then Maryland. And right now, this game is going to get uploaded on Monday, so obviously this is not relevant. But, you know, Maryland and LSU are going at it right now in the second round. Should be a good game. Got some good games going on. I'm recording this on a Saturday. But that's basically how March Madness is going for me. Obviously, my bracket's been busted, but I'm okay with that. I had a lot of fun with it. And, you know, I still think Duke's going to win. Like I said, we need Zion. Knicks need Zion to pull off this rebuilding, you know, plan that we're apparently is being rumored. You know, there's going into some NBA talk really quick for the video ends. If we get Zion, we also have some money that we can probably use to get Kyrie, and there's rumors of Kevin Durant being part of the team, which I'm not a fan of that one. Anyway, that's that. Hopefully if you have a perfect bracket, I hope it continues to stay that way, because how there are perfect brackets so far in the tournament is beyond me. Either way, my name is N0626, and I hope you guys enjoyed my March Madness talk. I'll catch you all on the next one.